Hello, good evening. In the last lesson, we have discussed about the concept of relations. All types of relations we have discussed in the first lesson. And it is very important to prove how a relation defined will be an equivalence relation. In the last lecture which I have left, that if you have to prove any relation which is an equivalence relation, then we need to prove it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Then only it can be a equivalence relation. After the concept of relation, I thought it's better to go for the exercise. Just I have taken the exercise 1.1 of your book. Exercise 1.1. And the first question is, determine whether each of the following relations are reflexive, symmetric and transitive. This is the NCERT book. In the first chapter, the first question. The relation R in the set A, it has the numbers from 1 to 14 and defined as R is equal to xy such that 3x minus y equal to 0. Now you have to prove and you have to check whether this relation R defined on the set A is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. Once again, for reflexive, I think if you remember, that means each relation, each member of itself should be related to itself, that is called reflexive. For symmetric, A related to B implies that B related to A, that is symmetric. And if A related to B and B related to C, and it implies that A related to C, that is transitive. Let us see now. If I ask you that tell me the relations are which all ordered pair we can have according to the conditions 3x minus y equal to 0. If I take x is equal to 1, if I take x is equal to 1, then the value of y will be 3. That means the first element ordered pair of this will be 1, 3. If I take x is equal to 2, then it will be 6, 3, 9, 4, 12, 5, 15. Can I write 5, 15? Why not? Why I cannot write 5, 15? Because if x is equal to 5, then y becomes 15. But in the set, we have the numbers from 1 to 14. That's why we have the ordered pair this 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, and 4, 12. These are the ordered pair. Now, we have to prove whether it is reflexive or not. The first part right here, the way of writing it, reflexive. For reflexive, you have to check. I can write this. See, for being reflexive, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 14 numbers are there. 1, 1 should be there. 2, 2 should be there. 3, 3 should be there. But it is not there. That's why it is not reflexive. I can write 1, 1 does not belong to R. 1, 1 does not belong to R. When 1, 1 does not belong to R, it means it is not true for all the elements belongs in the set R. And that's why it is not reflexive. That's why it is not reflexive. Reflexive. Second thing, in the second way I can write, that 3x minus y equal to 0. That means if I replace y by x, I will get 3x minus x is equal to 0. If I replace 3x minus x is equal to 0, it implies that 2x is equal to 0. It implies that x is equal to 0, which does not belong. X is equal to 0 does not belong to the set A. That set is also not reflexive. The third way to write it is A is related to A is not true for all A belongs to the given set A, and hence it is not reflexive. It is not reflexive. See, I have given the three way. First of all, I have given one example that 1, 1 does not belong to R, that's why it is not reflexive. Second, you know that 3x minus y equal to 0 is the given equation. Now 3x minus y equal to 0, y I have replaced by x, because you know that for being reflexive, x comma x should be related to itself, and therefore y should be replaced by x, and therefore 3x minus x equal to 0, it gives you x equal to 0, which is not in the set A, and that's why it is not reflexive, right? Now we'll prove and we'll check it for symmetric. B for symmetric. See now, 1, 3 belongs to this set A R, but 3, 1 does not belong to R. 1, 3 belongs to R, but 3, 1 does not belong to R, and that's why it is not symmetric. It is not symmetric. In the other way I can say, if A related to B does not imply that B related to A, for every A comma B belongs to the set A, where A and B are the elements of the set A, and therefore it is not reflexive, it's symmetric. Right? Similarly, now we will go for transitive. See what? For transitive. For transitive, we know that we should have three elements. Now see the elements we have. 1, 3 belongs to R, and 1, 3 belongs to R, and 3, 6 belongs to R, but 3, 6 does not belong to R. I think you can check it in that relation R, all the ordered pair. 1, 3 is there, right? 3, 9 is there. No, 3, 9 is there. 3, 9 is there. But 3, 9, 1, 3, 3, 9, and 1, 9 is not present over there. Because A related to B, B related to C, then you should have A related to C. Right? 1, 3 belongs to R, 3,9 belongs to R, but 1, 9 does not belong to R, and hence is not transitive. Therefore, it is not transitive. Other way I can say that A, B belongs to R, and B, C belongs to R, it does not imply that A, C belongs to R for every A, B, C belongs to the set A, and therefore it is not transitive. Right? See, this definition you have to remember. For all the questions, A related to B or AB belongs to R is the same thing. Don't get confused with this, that sometimes sir is writing A related to B, sometimes writing AB belongs to R. This both are the same thing. A related to B, or I can write AB belongs to R. Right? Both are the same thing. That's why the first question we have proved that it is neither reflexive, nor symmetric, nor transitive. It is nothing. It is no reflexive or symmetric or transitive. Similarly, we can do the other part of this question. Now, I'll go for the next question, that is question number 2. Rest all the parts of this question number 1. I think in the question number 1 in the book we have, there are 5 questions, and the 5th question has also 5 parts. That all the questions you will try your level best and you will solve it in your notebook, and then you let me know. Whether you, if you are not able to solve it, you will ask me again. Now the question number 2. Question number 2 is, so that the relation R in the set R, show that the relation R, so that the relation R in the set R of real numbers, of real numbers defined as R is equal to A comma B, such that A is less than equal to B square, is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. Right. Here, the relation R in the set R of a real number, very, very important. All the real numbers. Here, R relation R is defined as A comma B, such that A is less than equal to B square. If you think of any natural number, if I take 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, then you will find that this relation is correct. Because 1, if I take 1 comma 1 belongs to R, it means, it implies that 1 is less than equal to 1, no problem. If I take 2 comma 2 belongs to R, it implies that 2 is less than equal to 2 square, it implies that 2 is less than equal to 4. That it seems to be correct. It seems to be absolutely correct. But this R is not only the natural numbers. These define as a real number. That's why if we take R from the set R, if we take R is equal to, suppose if I take 1 by 2, if I take R is equal to 1 by 2, then you check now, let A is equal to 1 by 2. It implies that A comma A belongs to R. It implies that 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2 belongs to R. And when 1 by 2, 1 by 2 belongs to R, it means, it implies that 1 by 2 less than equal to 1 by 2 whole square. Right? It implies that 1 by 2 less than equal to 1 by 4. Now tell me, 1 by 2 is not less than 1 by 4. It is greater than 1 by 4. That means what? This relation is not correct. It means, which is not real, right? Which is not true. Which is not true, and therefore it is not reflexive. This I have taken the example. Or I can write A, let A belongs to R, then A less than equal to A square. A less than equal to A square is not true for every every A belongs to the given relation R, and that's why it is not reflexive. Even you can note it down and then you can check it. Now we'll prove that it is also not symmetric. It is also not symmetric. Fine? Should I go for it? Second part for symmetric. Right. Here you can take any number in the real number set. That would be better. In the real number set, if I take 2 and 3, let 2, 3 belongs to R. When 2, 3 belongs to this R, it means what? 2 is less than equal to 3 square, which seems to be absolutely correct. 2 is less than 9. But 3 square, that means but 3 is not less than equal to 2 square. This is false, which is not correct. Which is not correct. That means 2, 3 belongs to R, but 3, 2 does not belong to R, and therefore it is not symmetric. This again I have proved using examples. Now I'll use the definition of this. In the definition we'll write, let A, B belongs to R, which does not imply that B, A belongs to R. A, B belongs to R does not imply that B, A belongs to R for every A, B belongs to the given real number set R, and that's why it is not symmetric. Now I think it is clear. Now, transitive. For the transitive, we have discussed that it should have how many elements? 3 elements. A related to B, B related to C, and then A should be related to C. Now, the third part for transitive. Okay, we can have the different elements like that. 1, 2, let 1, 2 belongs to R. Of course, it implies that 1 is less than equal to 2 square. That is imply that 1 is less than equal to 4. This is absolutely correct. If I take now 2, 1.2 belongs to R, 2, 1.2 belongs to R, it implies that 2 is less than equal to, or I can take 2, 1.7 I can take, right? So now 2 less than equal to 1.7 whole square, that means 2 less than equal to 2.89, this is correct. That means 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 1.7 belongs to R. Then according to the reflexive rule, we should have 1, 1.7. 1, 1.7. 1, 1.7 belongs to R. It implies that 1 is less than 1.7 whole square. It implies that 1 is less than 2.89. Isn't it? 1 is related to 2, 2 is related to 1.7, and 1 is related to 1.7. right? Here it seems to be correct. 1 comma 2 belongs to R, 2 comma 1.7 belongs to R, and 1 comma 1.7 belongs to R, and that's why it seems to be transitive. But if I change the number over here, see, because the real number R is a very big set, right? Now suppose if I take 3 comma 2 belongs to R, another example I'll take now, 3 comma 2 belongs to R, right? Here it seems to be transitive, but now see, 3 comma 2 belongs to R, right? That means what? 3 is less than equal to 2 square, correct? Okay, now 2 comma 1.7 belongs to R. It implies that 2 is less than 2.89. This is also assumed to be correct. Isn't it? 3 less than 2 square, 3 less than equal to 4. 2 less than equal to 2.89 is also correct. Now, according to the definition, A comma B, B comma C, now you should have A comma C. So now see, 3 comma 1.7 belongs to R. It implies that 3 is less than equal to 2.89. Now see, here it seems to be fail. That's why, while you are taking the numbers, as a for example, you have to be very, very careful so that you can get the correct answer. Therefore, now what I can write? 3, 2 belongs to R, correct. 2, 1.7 belongs to R, correct. But 3, 1.7 does not belong to R, which is not true, which is not true. And therefore, it is not transitive. Okay, see, I have given this example to make you and to think over so many other numbers. It doesn't mean that if I have written 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that and you also go for it, you can have your own numbers to think about that. And then accordingly you can write the examples. You think over it. Because R is the really big number of set, real number. Now finally what I'll write, if anyone guess, yes. I write A related to B and B related to C, it does not imply to A related to C for every A, B, C belongs to R, and hence it is not transitive. Instead of writing on the board, thus I am telling you again, I will write finally with definition ki A, let A, B belongs to R, B, C belongs to R, and it does not imply that A comma C belongs to R for every A, B, C belongs to R, and hence it is not transitive. In the same way, we can do another question. Fine. On the basis of this, I think if I see the book, question number 2 I have done. Similarly, you can do question number 3, 4 and 5. Now, if I go for another question, question number 8. Question number 8. In question number 8, so that relation R in the set A, question number 8, show that the relation R in the set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 given by R is equal to A comma B, such that A minus B is even, is an equivalence relation. Okay, and the second part of the question is that show that all the elements of 1, 3, 5 are related to each other and all the elements of 2, 4 are related to each other, but no elements of 1, 3, 5 related to any element of 2, 4. This is the second part I will discuss when I complete the first part of this question. We have to prove it is equivalence relation. Okay. Now see, here A minus B is even. Even we can collect all the ordered pair of this relation R, or I can go with the examples which I have shown you discussed right now. Let A comma B is defined in the relation R such that A minus B is even. Now if I replace B by A, what I will get? Let A belongs to R. Imply that A minus A is equal to 0, which is even. That means see, 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. 3 minus 3, 0. 4 minus 4, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. Because in the ordered pair of R, if you collect the ordered pair of R, we'll have 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, and 5, 5. Tell me, can we have 1 minus 3 is alright, 1, 3. Why? Because 1 minus 3 is equal to 2. But I cannot have 1, 2. Why? Why not 1, 2? Because 1 minus 2 is equal to 1, which is not even. Which is not even. That's why 1, 3 is the ordered pair of this relation R. Similarly, 1, 4 cannot be the ordered pair of this relation R, but 1, 5 will be the ordered pair of this relation R. And that's why instead of writing and collecting all the ordered pair, better you collect all the ordered pair, then also we can write the examples. Let, I have given for the, I have just going for the simple with the definition that A minus A is equal to 0, which is even, and it is true for each and every member. That A belongs to R, it implies that A related to A for every A belongs to R, and hence it is reflexive. The first part is done. First part reflexive. Second part for symmetric. Now for symmetric, you should have the two elements. Let AB belongs to R. When AB belongs to R, it means what? It implies that A minus B is even. And you know that when A minus B is even, it also implies that B minus A is even. Yes or no? When A minus B is even, then B minus A will be also even. And it implies that B comma A belongs to R. That means what? AB belongs to R. It implies that BA belongs to R. For every A and B belongs to the given relation R, set R. And therefore, it is a symmetric relation. And therefore, it is a symmetric relation. Now the third one I have to prove what? For transitive I have to prove. Third part. For transitive. Okay. Let A B belongs to R. It implies that A minus B is even. Yes or no? And when A minus B is even, can I write that mod of A minus B is equal to 2m or 2k, multiple of 2. Even means what? Multiple of 2? right? A minus B is equal to 2m. Also, B comma C belongs to R. It implies that what? B minus C is even. It implies that what? B minus C is equal to 2n, I can say 2n multiple of 2. Okay. AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R. That means A minus B is even, B minus C is also even. Now I have to find out, can I write A minus B plus B minus C? Can I write A minus B? Now we have, can I write A minus B plus B minus C? That means this part can I write, and that is equal to what? A minus B is equal to, I have written here 2m, plus B minus C, I have written here 2n. 2m, that means twice of m plus n, that is also even. Isn't it? Or other way I can write that A minus B plus B minus, if I add it, what will happen? This B and B will be cancelled. And I can say that A is equal to C, A minus C, that is equal to A minus C. A minus C. And therefore it will be also even. But better is to go like this, which I have written first. A minus B plus B minus C. A minus B is equal to twice of m because it is even. B minus C is equal to twice of m because it is even. And therefore their sum, twice of m plus twice of n, I can write twice of m plus n, and therefore it is also even. It means what? AB belongs to R. AB belongs to R. And B comma C belongs to R. It implies that A comma C belongs to R for every A, B, C belongs to the given set R, and hence it is transitive. Now it comes to the final statement. The relation R, which was defined as AB and A minus B is even, is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Now please write it in your notebook. Since the given relation R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, and that's why it is an equivalence relation. The first part of this question is proved that it is an equivalence relation. Now, the second part of the question is elements of 1, 3, 5. Elements of 1, 3, 5. 1, 3, 5 and 2, 4. See now, the elements of 1, 3, 5 and 2, 4 are related to each other. How they are related to? See, 1 minus 3, 2. 1 minus 5, 4. See, 1 minus 3 is equal to 2. 1 minus 5 is equal to 4. 3 minus 5 is equal to 2. All are even. All are even. Okay, now check here. 2 comma 4. 2 minus 4. 2 minus 4 is also 2, which is also even. That's why, what is said that the elements of 1, 3, 5 and 2, 4 are related to each other. That means their difference are even. Their difference are even, and that's why they are related to each other. But no elements of 1, 3, 5 and 2, 4 are related to one another. It means what? 1 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 4, 3. 3 minus 2, 1. 5 minus 2, 3. 3 minus 4, 1. 5 minus 4, 1. That means difference of these among these, between these two, have what? Their difference is not even. That's why they are not related to each other. Now, see the statement of the question. We'll write, finally answer, we'll write like yes. All the elements of, please write it in your notebook.
all the elements of 1, 3, 5 are related to each other, and all the elements of 2, 4 are related to each other as their difference is an even number. But no elements of 1, 3, 5 is related to any element of 2, 4 because their difference are odd. That's the final answer of this question number 8. Now, I can do more of the questions, but I think now you can try your level best to do rest of the questions of the exercise. You can do almost all the question of the exercise 1.1, complete it, because the second exercise has the concept of function. That's why in the next lesson, I'll go for the introduction of the function and then I'll go for the questions. In the meantime, now you have time to complete the exercise 1.1. You solve it, and if you find any difficulty, any problem in any particular questions, you are free to share with me and I'll be very, very happy in correcting that way. Thank you very much.